hard time taking it seriously, just so you know.
I'm going to ask who your favorite teammate is, and that question right there is going to shape the rest of your career. You answer that wrong, I'm going to ask the tough questions. Action.
Nate, first and foremost, right here. Put her there.
Yeah. You know, I think, me personally, I have no idea what your answer could be for this, but who is your favorite guy on the team?
Well, you know, if I said anybody else, I think the interview would stop right now and our friendship would end. So, you know, I have to say the guy that I sit next to on the plane ride to and from road games.
Right.
That'd be Nick Bahe.
Okay. Can we cut tape here a little bit? You know, I've been noticing that you've been acting pretty stressed out lately. I've been seeing some bags under the eyes. You know, you constantly look tired. I hear you got a grueling academic schedule right now.
I do.
Your class schedules, I mean, as tough as it gets. It's almost like you're in med school or law school. I mean, talk a little bit about your class. Notice how I didn't say classes.
My first scheduled class is Monday night, next Monday night.
Right.
Which is a applied guitar class. I'm trying to learn how to play an instrument, something that I've always been interested in.
If that doesn't sound like the toughest thing I've ever heard, I tell you what, applied guitar. Now, talk a little bit about you were, I think, if I'm wrong, you were 11 points behind.
10
points behind a certain guy that we're around quite a bit.
Yeah.
You could even call him, Coach McKenna.
You know, before that game, we were talking about how I was pretty close to beating him. Mm-hmm. And he's like, well, you know, we didn't have a three-point line back then, so I would have scored a lot more points if I'd had a three-point line. That's his excuse.
There's
you know,
always
of course.
An excuse.
Of course, he's just jealous.
Yeah.
Okay, something the viewers might not know about you is that you are actually going into broadcasting. You want to be a sports broadcaster. But you do some pretty good impressions of people. And a couple of coaches that the viewers might be aware of, Coach Self, Coach Altman, and Coach Krzyzewski at Duke. And viewers know that you were at Kansas, and Coach Self was your coach, so
right.
Have a pretty good impression of him. Take it away, Coach Self.
Let's take a look at this here. First possession. Oh, boy, I mean, I tell you what. Wayne, you're tough. God almighty, you're tough in there. In that block, you're just down low. You got a presence. Not half the time, all the time, presence. So I'm talking about having a presence, God almighty. Oh, look at that effort, Aaron. That's pitiful. Pitiful.
This is second year with Coach Altman,
mm-hmm.
And I think we have some phrases that we're both aware of that he uses time and time again. So,
okay.
Coach Altman,
I'm sorry, first of all, Coach Altman. But all right, guys, first with the good here. We've got a good possession here, a spread. But hold on, let's pause it here, guys. Look at all the straight up and down standing right here. The game's not played. Like this, guys. Got to get down low here, guys. All right, let's see a good possession here. All right. Posh. That ball is popping around. See where we got the defense? All of them shifted. No one knows where they're at here, fellas. But good bent knees. Good bash. Bash is great.
Good bash.
But we're popping that thing around. That's great basketball, fellas. That's how you hang a banner right there. Those type of basketball plays.
Don't have any expressions that Coach Krzyzewski uses,
right,
but we have a certain commercial that I'm sure the viewers are aware of.
I don't view myself as a basketball coach. I view myself as a leader that happens to coach basketball. When I have you leave Duke University, I don't want you armed with just a jump shot. I want you armed for life. That's why I use American Express.